What life lurks in the deepest, darkest parts of our planet's oceans? These unexplored remote areas hold secrets about animal behavior that humans have never seen. And because there are more questions than answers about life at the bottom of the ocean, our imaginations run wild with tales of sea serpents like the Kraken or the Loch Ness Monster. But there are otherworldly creatures living thousands of feet below the surface, and they've adapted to their hostile environment over millions of years by taking on some unbelievably cool, and in some cases, seriously odd physical characteristics. There are more than 200 species of anglerfish, which live in the dark depths of the Atlantic and Antarctic oceans, as far as a mile below the surface. These carnivores are usually brown or gray, and can grow up to 3 feet long, though most are around a foot long. Anglerfish have giant heads, big mouths, and sharp teeth that make them look like something straight out of a horror film. Only female anglerfish have the appendage that tells the story of their name. They have a section of their spine that juts out above their mouth and acts as a fishing pole. The very tip has bioluminescent bacteria that light up when the anglerfish wiggles it to attract prey. Because deep-sea animals are seldom seen, it's easy to think of them as being relatively immune to effects of human activities. But overfishing, ocean acidification, and expanding low oxygen zones in the ocean could wipe out key organisms and cause irreversible changes in deep-sea food webs. Such shifts in deep-sea biodiversity could directly impact marine mammals, human fisheries, or even Earth's climate. In some species of anglerfish, the males are tiny, with simplified body features, and they live as parasites on the females. This is thought to be an adaptation to save energy, allowing the females to feed on whatever food is available. The males seem to have evolved for one purpose only, to find a female and deliver sperm. The home range of the Nautilus is generally deepwater marine areas in the Western Pacific, American Samoa, and the coastal Indian Ocean. During the day, the Nautilus can be found up to 2,000 feet deep, but the animals move to shallower water at night to feed on hermit crabs and fish. Like octopus and squid, this gorgeous chambered nautilus is a cephalopod, meaning its feet, in this case tentacles, are attached to its head. The nautilus has terrible vision, as its primitive eyes have no lenses. Instead, it works like a pinhole camera. Its protective brown and white striped shell has chambered compartments called camarae. The chambers are closed, except for the large outermost one. That section contains the animal with up to 90 tentacles. The nautilus fills the 30 or more inner camarae with gas to stay in place or adds liquid to the chambers to dive. The nautilus first appeared roughly 4.5 billion years ago and has since changed little. The whiplash squid hovers at the ocean bottom as deep as 4,920 feet in a vertical position. The squid resembles a tuning fork in this stance and uses it to remain in its feeding zone. This creature uses the fins on its mantles to move through the water and hold its hover position. Some have bioluminescent spots called photophores that produce light on the skin or around the eyes. Scientists know very little about the whiplash squid because until modern deep-sea submersibles spotted them in 1992, they were only able to examine dead specimens. The ROVs and AUVs of the years beginning in 2011 have brought back much better footage. Mariana Hadal snailfish, Pseudoliparus suirei, have been spotted as deep as 26,831 feet, more than 5 miles below the surface, in the Mariana Trench. This habitat, called the Hadal Zone, lends its name to the fish. These fish may look like cute tadpoles, but they are the top predators in their habitat. Due to their deep-sea home, they have evolved to have thinner muscles, larger stomachs, livers, and eggs, and more flexible cartilage bones than their shallow water relatives. Scientists estimate that these fish withstand pressure equivalent to the Eiffel Tower resting on someone's big toe. The common fangtooth resides in the dark depths of the ocean, some more than 16,000 feet deep. These fish mostly inhabit tropical and temperate waters, but scientists also have documented them in the subarctic. Despite its ferocious appearance, the fangtooth is relatively small, only about 7 inches. Those teeth are so long, however, that the fish can't close their mouth. Many things remain a mystery about this fish. Some scientists suggest that the fangtooth is a fierce predator that actively seeks out prey. Others suggest that they, like many deep-sea organisms, prefer an ambush style of hunting. Oddly enough, they swallow their prey whole and don't use those teeth to chew first. The cookie-cutter shark prefers warm water and lives in oceans near the equator at depths of 1,000 feet. This stuff of nightmare's mouth takes circular cookie-shaped chunks of flesh from its victims. A horrifying visual, yes, but these sharks are parasites, which means they harm, but do not kill, other fish or marine mammals. As far as sharks go, these are on the petite side, measuring up to 19 inches. Previously, cookie-cutter sharks had the common name of cigar sharks for two reasons. First, their bodies are long and cylindrical like a cigar, and second, they have a dark collar around their gills that looks like the band on a cigar. They also have bioluminescent light organs that make them appear dark from above and light from below. Researchers think that the dark bar, combined with the illuminated main body, tricks prey into thinking a small fish is above them. The unlovely viperfish haunts the tropical and temperate ocean at depths of up to 9,000 feet. It generally lives about 5,000 feet below the surface during the day. At night, it ascends to shallower water to hunt. This predator is another deep-sea fish with an outsized mouth, a giant lower jaw, and fang-like teeth. Like the anglerfish, viperfish have light-producing organs that they dangle near their bodies to attract prey. And if that lure doesn't work, these fast swimmers rush their victims and impale them on teeth so long they don't fit in their mouth. This foot-long fish comes in a variety of colors, from green to silver to black to blue. Frilled sharks are another deep-sea dweller that is rarely seen because they most often live about 1,600 to 3,280 feet underwater. They might even be the source of sea monster stories with their eel-like bodies, as they have about 300 triangular teeth arranged in 25 rows. The frilled shark grows as much as 5 or 6 feet long. Interestingly, no one has ever seen a frilled shark eat. Lanternfish bring their own light to their habitat, 1,300 to 3,000 feet below the surface during the day. At night, they ascend to feed as high up as just 82 feet below the sea level. The lanternfish uses photophores on its body and snout to provide the light to see with its large eyes. These tiny swimmers are only 1 to 6 inches long and live about 1,000 feet deep in waters worldwide. Lanternfish are an essential part of the food chain, serving as the primary food source to larger animals like squid, tuna, salmon, whales, and penguins. Unfortunately, lanternfish consume plastic debris from the ocean that then becomes food for other animals. Communities of giant tube worms form over a mile underwater in the Pacific Ocean around hydrothermal vents. These fissures on the ocean floor spout scalding, acidic water and poisonous gas. But even in that dark, hostile environment, the swaying white tubes can grow up to 8 feet tall at a rate of up to 33 inches a year. They have no mouth or digestive system. Instead, they survive via a symbiotic relationship with the bacteria living inside them. And true to their name, they are the heaviest known worms in the world. Scientists first discovered giant tube worms in 1977 off the coast of the Galapagos Islands in the Galapagos Rift, roughly 8,000 feet below the surface. These elongated fish live at depths of 656 feet, but some live as far down as 3,280 feet. Oarfish are said to have inspired tales of sea serpents through the years. Looking at pictures of oarfish that wash up on beaches, it's easy to see why. The world's longest bony fish can grow up to 56 feet long and weigh 600 pounds. Found all over the world, these fish aren't sought for their gelatinous meat, though some people trophy hunt for them. Instead of scales, they have tubercles covered in a material called guanine. When they come to the surface, their skin becomes soft and is easily damaged. Thank you for watching. See you soon.